It's Wild 94.1, Joey Franchize here, Mr. Quicksand himself, man. 50 million views. I gotta do the Dr. Evil pinky to the, you know what I mean?
Gajillion.
Oh man, Morray, how you feeling, man? It's a great time. Records going up crazy. Obviously, the video's doing numbers. Talk to me, bro.
No cap, bro. I'm blessed. Like I'm super happy. I woke up today on the good side of the bed, having some good breakfast. Got me some good smooches from the babies, nigga. It's a good day, baby.
Always a good day when that's going on. What you have for breakfast? What's the go-to?
This morning we had some hash browns, some eggs, and some bacon. Not the home fries. Like when you cut the potatoes up real small, fire, bro.
No cap. Always hits the spot. So tell me a little bit about yourself, man. Fayetteville, man, holding it down. Another Fayetteville star on the rise. What's it like, man, coming out the city, having a big record that's actually, you know, everywhere from Fayetteville to the world?
No cap. It's a good pressure. I love it because I feel like it gives me a reason to work harder because now I know a lot of eyes on me. There's a lot of kids, a lot of teenagers, a lot of other rappers that's watching me like, yo, what moves can I make to get there? And I'm glad that I have the talent to show them. And I'm glad that I'm going to be able to show them.
What were some of those inspirations coming up?
A lot of inspirations was like gospel music. It was like Karen Clark Shield, Kelly Price, Jay Moss. And then like when I got older, so I listened to music myself out of the church, was like Drake. Drake was really a big, intricate part of my life as far as music. Understand that you ain't got to sing or rap. You could do both on your own track and feature yourself. I said, oh, shit, I'm going to do this. It made me feel like I didn't have to pick and choose. You know, of course, it took me a lot longer to get what I wanted to say out, but at least he gave me the basis so I could do both.
I love the sound too, man. Where'd you like kind of harness that? You know what I mean? I know you were just talking about like, you know, just like what you said with Drake and allowing, you know, people to rap and sing and kind of harmonize, you know, in their music. Where did you sing at a young age? Were you in like any choirs, anything like that coming up? I know you mentioned gospel music.
Yes, sir. I stayed in the church. Hey, when you're from the South, that you got no choice. You that Monday night prayer, Wednesday night prayer, Friday night service, Saturday night choir rehearsal, and Sunday night service. So like that's just how it works. So I stayed in the church and grown up on that background and hearing the singers and how they sang, not even sing, but how they sang and how they carried notes and undertones and how brutally honest the church is will definitely make you get your pitch right. Something about Sister Johnson saying, baby, that ain't your song. It will hurt your heart.
Oh my God, yo, and I love it on Quicksand because I know your sound is very, very different and it's very unique, something I haven't really heard, and especially the way there's a part in Quicksand, I don't know the lyrics off the head, but like, I've never heard, yo, I was like, oh, yo, I'm like, yo, this is an immediate slap the minute I heard it, so tell me where that flow kind of came from. Was that something you just like messing around with in the studio and you just like, you know, this kind of works? Because man, it really, I haven't heard anything like that. So you really kind of secured that spot as far as like the flow, you know?
I ain't gonna lie to you. When I listen to beats, I try to make my voice an instrument with the beat. And when that part came up, I don't even know what made me change it, but I just wanted to switch my flow up so it sound nothing like what I was already doing. Because no cap, another reference is to Drizzy, how he changed his flow like 5-6 times in the verse. Right. Like, that's what you got to do to keep people involved. And then when I came up with that, two dogs with that flow, if I hop in the cool. Like, I don't even know where it came. The words came from me, but the flow just came from nowhere, bro. And because I wrote it differently, but I recorded it differently. You know what I mean? Right. That wasn't my rhythm when I wrote it. But when I recorded it, that was rhythm. It just changed.
Bro, I love it. I love that style, bro. Like especially that part of the record, man. When you get busy on that flow, I was like, bro, like mind blown. But also, you know, is there a project that you're working on? What's cooking up over there?
Right now, I got my mixtape coming out. Hopefully, very soon. I'm still getting the finishing touches on it right now. But I'm definitely trying to give people more of me, learn more of me, get to know me. I don't have any features on this mixtape because I really want people to understand who I am first. And I also want people in the industry to know, like, yo, I can carry a song as well. So like when it comes to the business, they understand Morray's a good asset. And when it comes to the fans, they know Morray is going to give us all. So I just want to please both sides of the party, so I please myself.
There you go, man. That's the energy to have, bro. And I love the energy you have. You know what I'm saying? You up and at it.
Yes, sir.
I got to tell you, too, like, you know, being from Fayetteville has, and with the record doing what it is, has that phone rang from, you know, the Fayetteville, you know, God himself right now, J. Cole?
Yeah, no cap. Yeah, I've talked to J. Cole plenty of times. Like, no cap. He's really a humble-ass, honest nigga. Like, when you talk to him, like, you got to get in your serious bag because he make you want to be super real and come forth real. Like, I fuck with boy. He's super solid, bro. No cap.
That's cool, man.
It's funny that I can talk about J. Cole like that when I didn't know that nigga. Like, that shit is crazy. Let's just say that shit out loud. Like, the fact that I talked to boy, that shit is crazy.
Bro, it's up from there, you know what I mean?
Like, yeah.
That's all you need, man, to keep that battery going, you know what I mean? That battery in your back to go harder.
Yes, sir.
Tell me a little bit about the city, Fayetteville, man. I know Cole's rapped about it many times on the record, but I'd love to hear your perspective on it and just kind of see what the scene's like in that area, because it seems like there's so many cats that, you know, there's talent out there, and I feel like it's on the rise, and it's really starting to get its shine.
Yeah, honestly, like, no cap, Fayetteville is... There's so much talent in Fayetteville. Like, not even just rappers, like, singers, dancers, actors, fucking philanthropists, whatever. There's so much shit down here that I know if the right eye seen it, my city would go so further than it ever could have gone. I feel like we need a bigger light. And it's so much love. It's just like every city, don't get me wrong, there's still niggas who kill each other. It's still stupid shit. But it's more love than anything. Because when you walk in my city, you can see a fucking complete stranger and they be like, well, what's up, my boy? Oh, what's up, my boy? How you feeling? Like, I don't even know this nigga, bro. We just spoke to each other because that's how it is. If you come with respect, you get it back. And I think I learned that shit from Fayetteville because when you around complete strangers, you can have a complete conversation without no aggression, without no bullshit. How can you not be okay with that, bro?
Yeah, nah, that's real right there, man. And being from this city, I know you got it on your back right now, holding it down. You know, is there other things that you are trying to get with? I love your personality too. Do you ever see yourself like trying to do stuff in like TV or movies and stuff like that? It seems like, you know, the sky's the limit from here on out.
I ain't gonna lie to you. I would love to do any of that. Like, growing up, you watch a lot of TV, so you always like try to see if you can fucking act. You know, I would love to give it a shot, but. That's like further down the line right now. I just want to just focus on this music and really see how far I can go with my first dream before I focus on the second one.
Respect that. Quicksand is going crazy right now. Now you say you got the mixtape on the way. You got a title for it?
Yes, sir, I do. I was going for, let me see, Street Sermons Volume 1.
Street Sermon Volume 1.
Yes, sir.
That church aspect to it. All right, respect that.
Just because it makes sense about who I am, because and everything that I do, I want to give him his recognition as well.
That's cool. I dig that. And anybody that you work with, is it just straight you? You got any features on it?
It's just me.
That's cool. Any producers that you're working with?
I work with Foreign Got 'Em, 808 Southside. I believe, I'm not sure if I have to have one with Mello, but you know, people like that always come into the studio and like give you pointers. So either way, they help regardless. I've had a lot of producers just, you know, talk to me and give me advice. So the ones that I didn't shout out, still thank y'all for even giving a nigga the time of the day to talk to me and give me some advice. You feel me? Like niggas like Glock, Sled, and fuck with me, Top. A lot of producers that showed up, just thank y'all. Thank y'all.
Word. And real quick to go back to Quicksand being the hit singer. I know we talk about this a lot. I mean, it's the only thing to talk about as far as it being 50 million views, and obviously the world's it's on display right now. And it's interesting these days to see how music is discovered. I mean, we see it doing numbers streaming wise too, and that's really how I discovered it by the playlist. You know, how did you know that this was it? Like Quicksand, this was the record.
I didn't know until it got its first like 100,000 views, and I put it in like a bio before too. Just when I seen the number of 100,000 and nobody did get that in my city besides me, that's when I knew like, yo, I might have tapped into something a little different that may get some traction. And I still didn't think it would get 50 million. Like, I just found that shit out like yesterday. So, you feel me? Like, that shit's a lot to take in. You feel me?
Oh,
so,
no, I feel that.
It's a blessing, and I'm humble, I'm grateful, and I'm happy at the end of the day.
And I'm happy for you, man. I can't wait to hear the project. Looking forward to it real soon. No date on it yet? Just
not a date yet, but just know it's I'm working hard on it.
Bet that. And in the meantime, we're going to continue running quick, staying up here at the station, Y94.1. Bro, appreciate you. Keep doing your thing, man. We got to get you out here to Tampa.
Okay,
we got to put you on the vibes out here, bro.
I got to see what it's like. I ain't never been. I got to go, bro.
Oh, everything's beautiful about it. Trust me. I don't know what you've heard about Tampa, but listen, everything.
I ain't heard nothing. The first time going to be when I hear from you.
There you go. Are you into kicks or anything at all? Like your steez, you know what I mean? Like fashion-wise, like what do you want?
I'm not really a fashion nigga. Like I didn't grow up with a lot. So it's hard for me to get into that shit now. Yeah. I'm a sweatsuit type nigga, sweatpants, t-shirts, same, regular smuggling. You feel me? Bro, so
I got a hoodie and sneakers
right now.
Dead ass, but hey, you mess, you fuck with me, I'm put you on to some kicks, man. You gonna mess Thank around you. Be a sneakerhead.
Show so. Me the way, brother. Show me
I will.
Way.
I will guide you, my friend. Yo, we'll be in touch, man. Definitely keep in contact, and I definitely love to like have you out here. Are you doing are you booking any performances or anything like that?
I have one coming up at Apple Chew. Okay. Definitely trying to get that rocking. I think I have another one in Arlington, Texas, I believe. I'm trying to see right now who want me. I'm trying to show up.
Tampa wants you. Like the records up. So yeah.
Hey, hit the vibes then. Hit the proper channels. Let's get crazy.
I'm gonna hit up Gaffy, and then we'll try to piece it up from there.
Let's go.
All right. My G. Yo, bless, bro. Congratulations on everything, man. I'll talk to you soon.
One, you know the vibes.
Love, peace.